Well, good morning. We welcome you here to Liberty Baptist Church. Had 114 in Sunday school today. Thankful for everyone that was here. And hopefully when we get the rest of our fall breakers back, we'll be in the 120s again. But it's really great to see everyone here today. And thank you for praying for Joellen and myself, because we were on the Alabama Gulf Shore, and because of Hurricane Michael, we left on Tuesday morning, left a couple days early, and I'm really glad we did, because the further we got, we saw that it was hard to get a hotel room, it was hard to get gasoline. And so thank you for praying for us, because we made it back safely. Got a few announcements that I want to make here this morning. Want to remind you that tonight we are not having evening service, and this is because of the John Chapman visitation funeral tonight. In case you didn't get that information, the visitation is from 5 to 7 at Schubert's, with the funeral to follow. And then the burial is going to be tomorrow at the church cemetery here, 11 a.m. So please remember the John Chapman family. Also want to remind you that today we are collecting items for storehouse. This is World Hunger Day. And so what we do is we seek this as an opportunity to help alleviate the needs that are here in Morgan County. So we have a box out there, and I've had people say, well, can I bring it a little bit later? Yes, you can, but don't bring it a whole lot later, okay? So we encourage you to help with that. Tomorrow night, Vision Committee meets at 6:15. We have our regular activities on Wednesday night. And then next Sunday, we are going to be taking up a special offering as you leave the worship service next Sunday morning to support Tennessee Baptist Disaster Relief. And we will be using this offering to support the disaster relief for both hurricanes that have hit. So we'll have further instructions next Sunday on that, but wanted to let you be aware of that. And the great part about that is that 100% of what you give is going to help with the supplies that people need, because we already have the structure in place in terms of our state mission board, and then all the people that are actually serving there in a disaster area are all volunteers. So that means that any money that's given will go to help with materials that are needed, or with gasoline and other expenses that they have in terms of keeping their units up and running. Next Sunday, we also got a different schedule. The personnel committee is going to be meeting at 4:30, adult choir at 4:45. So that's next Sunday, and also the adult choir is going to meet at 4:30 today, so we don't want them to miss a practice. And then we've got a bonfire. Now I'm going to jump back to the 21st, a bonfire next Sunday night, and we need some folks to sign up for some of the items that we need for the bonfire, and pray that we don't have rain like we've got today. Also, we know that we've had some brochures passed out. Valerie's been doing that, so Valerie, come and share a little bit of update on that.
Good morning. As part of the Vision Committee, we determined from the survey last year that we needed to start focusing more on small groups. So this year I was picked to be the small group director. I don't really know what I'm doing, but I've got a lot of good people around me to kind of walk me through it, so hopefully it'll go well. I handed out this flyer. Please review this and be thinking about it. We want to get small groups going in January. If you're ready to go, we'll get you going sooner, but January is the target date. And if you'll look up at the top, it has just a little brief description of what a small group is. Spiritual growth opportunities consisting of an ongoing time-specific or one-time seminars of various sizes held at various locations. So it's kind of a lot of flexibility there. We can have a small group seminar that's like a Saturday meeting you know, and it's for 4 hours or, you know, something like that. Or we can have a 6-week that we focus on one topic, or we can have an ongoing group. So it's a wonderful, wonderful experience, and it's not tied down to Sunday morning. Sunday morning Sunday school is wonderful, and it's always going to be here. But the small groups gives us a lot more flexibility. It can be on Sunday night, it can be on Wednesday night, it can be basically any night of the week and that you have a group that wants to get together. It can be here at the church, or it can be in your home or in some other facility. You know, if you wanted to go to Hardee's and have one, you know, you might get some people interested that aren't part of, you know, that are lost. So there's all kinds of ways to do it. And it says, would you like to, and it lists about 10 different kind of things we could do. And that's just that's just barely the tip of the iceberg. I mean, there's so many things that you can do in a study group, and you can focus on one issue, or you can focus on one concern. You can learn how to pray better, or you can, just so many things that you can make a study group about. The one thing we do want to do is we want to make sure it's all biblically based. It is for fellowship. It is for getting to know each other and loving on each other. And we're going to do it in a Christian way. We're going to do it based on what the Lord says in his word. So it is all biblically based, but it is a little bit more free and loose. You can bring food. You can do whatever you want, you know, and you can meet wherever you want. So that's what we're looking forward to. And I'm going to have a survey that's going to start next week. And what I'm going to do is I will hand out, just like I did today, I will hand out the survey, but there will also be extras out in the lobby, and I'm going to put a box out there. You don't have to do the survey next week. You can think about it. You can pray about it. And I'd like for you to start praying now about it, about what are the things you would like to have in a study group. Where would you like to meet? What times of the day are best for you, or the evening, or days of the week? Those kinds of things. And how would you like to participate? Would you like to be a participant, a leader, maybe even a supporter, you know, providing snacks, you know, whatever, things like that. There's all kinds of things. So be thinking about that, be praying about that, and be looking for ways that you can join in on this. This is going to be so much fun. It's going to take us to another level of fellowship. I'm so looking forward to this. And then finally, down at the very bottom, I put in small print, but if you want to get in touch with me, if you have any questions or anything, you can call me, you can email me. My email's on there. You can send me a message on Facebook. I'm on Facebook. Don't send public messages. You know, let's keep this communication on Messenger in Facebook. And then, of course, my phone number. You can call me or you can text me. Now, sometimes I have my phone's turned off at work, so if I don't answer you immediately, leave a voicemail. I'll get back to you. Okay? All right. And I'll be available. Give me a call, text me, whatever, if you have any questions between now and next week. But please be praying and thinking about how you'd like to be involved in one of these small groups. Okay? Have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Valerie. And we'll be hearing from the Vision Committee a little bit later in the service about their work and get a progress on what they're doing. It's really great to see you here this morning. And as we go to Lord in prayer, let's remember Laura Fountain, as she will be having surgery tomorrow at UT Hospital, and pray for the other folks that are on our list that need to be lifted up at this time. So let's go to Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, dear God, we come to you today mindful of the need that we have for you in our lives. And I know that some people come in here today and they're worried about work, or they're worried about a diagnosis that they've received. Others are worried about something in their family or loss of a loved one. And Heavenly Father, I'm thankful that we can come into this house of worship today and that you can touch our hearts and you can encourage us with whatever problem we have or whatever struggle we're facing, that you can encourage us and help us through this worship service. We're thankful that you forgive us of our sins. We're thankful that you shower your grace upon us, even though we are so unworthy of the blessings that you give us. We come here today to worship you, to acknowledge that you are foremost in our lives, and we honor you, Heavenly Father, with this time, with our praise, and with all that is within us. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
We welcome you to Liberty Baptist Church this morning. And Valerie, I like the idea of that small group at Hardee's. Anybody else like the idea of a Hardee's biscuit? I think there's several. We may need to have two or three groups there. I'm just saying. I encourage you to stand, if you would, as we sing hymn number 59, Mighty is Our God. We are happy to have you here in the Lord's house this morning. And we were talking in the choir room about, even though it's a dreary day outside, about what a wonderful glow there is inside here in the Lord's love. And truly, it is wonderful to be here in God's house this morning. I'm glad that you're here to be with us today.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns.
anyone near you this morning. And I hope that somebody greeted you here in this place this morning. Let's sing hymn number 491, an appropriate song for a Sunday that doesn't have a lot of sun visible yet. Let's sing hymn number 491, Shine, Jesus, Shine.